This video is made possible by Brilliant.org. The first 755 people to sign up with Brilliant will get 20% off their premium subscription. So here's the problem that this video is going to be talking about. How long is the coast of the United States? If you look at any map and see America, you might think that it's easy. Just measure the outline of the country and you have your answer. Several people and organizations have already tried this though, like the Congressional Research Institute that calculated it to be 12,383 miles, a second study from them that changed it to 29,093 miles, the CIA puts it at 19,924 miles, and a study from NOAA calculated the shoreline to be 95,471 miles. You may have noticed that all of these numbers are different, which is weird because they're all just measuring the same coastline. So what's going on? Let's move over to a smaller country like the United Kingdom and measure the coastline of Great Britain to get a clearer picture. Obviously, the coast of Britain isn't straight. Every time you look closer at a line that looks straight, you'll see more curves and bends. So how do you measure the length of the coast if every time you look more closely, it never actually becomes straight? You end up using the smallest measurement unit that's feasible. So if you were to measure the British coast using lengths of 100 kilometers, you'd end up using 28 of them and get an answer of 2,800 kilometers. But if you shortened your measuring units down to 50 kilometers, you'd end up using 68 of them and get an answer of 3,400 kilometers, which is 600 kilometers longer than your first measurement was. This is called the coastline paradox, and anybody's answer to how long a coastline is depends on what size of measurement they're using. First observed by a guy named Lewis Fry Richardson back in 1951 as a way to explain how Portugal and Spain had come up with totally different answers to their mutual border length, the coastline paradox has been annoying cartographers ever since. Basically, the smaller the unit of measurement you use to measure a coastline, the longer your answer will become. You could theoretically go all the way down to the molecular level for your measurement unit, but if you do that, the length of the coast seems to approach infinity. It doesn't seem to make any sense that you could have a defined space with a finite area like Great Britain be surrounded by an infinitely long perimeter. But there's a similar concept that can be found in mathematics called fractals. A coach snowflake is probably the easiest way to visualize this concept. So imagine a triangle with equal sides of 1. Put another triangle on each side with equal lengths of 1/3. You can keep repeating this process forever, and if you zoom in on the snowflake, it essentially goes on forever. When you zoom back out to the original starting point, you're left with a shape that has a finite area, but an infinitely long perimeter. A lot of coastlines around the world have similar properties to this. So you can keep zooming in and zooming in on the coast of Britain, and the coastline will continue to look roughly the same, no matter how far down the rabbit hole you go. As mentioned previously, you'll eventually hit the molecular level if you zoom in far enough, and you'll be measuring a beach by counting atoms. If you did this forever, you'd find the coast of Britain to probably be millions of kilometers in length, which just isn't very practical or easy to understand. There's also the minor problem that coastlines tend to change all the time with erosion. Every time a wave crashes on a beach, its shape is changed by a little, and that is really hard to accurately pin down. On top of this, sea levels are rising around the world, which can drastically alter the way a coastline looks. In extreme cases, like what might happen to the Maldives in a few decades, entire landmasses may become completely swallowed. On the other hand, there's the Dutch, who have been adding land to their coastline now for over 700 years. The point is, Earth is constantly evolving, so good luck going out to a coast with a microscope and measuring the length that way. Every number you see online or in a book for how long a coastline is basically just a guess or an estimation. The true value is impossible to know, and that is the coastline paradox. Just take a look at this list from the CIA World Factbook on the countries with the longest coastlines for a few surprises. According to them, Canada is first, which kind of makes sense, but the really surprising one is Norway in second place. At a first glance, Norway's coast doesn't seem too long, especially when compared with countries like Russia or the United States. But when you zoom in closer, Norway's coast gets pretty wild. Just look at all these nooks and crannies and islands and fjords. The CIA puts the total length of this coast at 58,133 kilometers, which, if you stretch that out all in a vertical line, would circle the entire Earth at the equator almost 1.5 times. times. If you want to kill your entire weekend and see the coastline paradox in action, try measuring the Norwegian coast from the south all the way around to the border with Russia, and put a comment down comparing your answer with everybody else's. Of course, if you want to do this, or any other coastal measurement, you'll need an understanding of geometry, algebra, and fractals. Numbers and concepts like these are confusing for a lot of people, including myself. It was confusing for me at least until I tried Brilliant.org. Rather than just teaching you how to do algebra problems by memorizing things, they start by teaching the intuitive ideas behind algebra. By playing through their puzzles, you get to understand how algebra works. Brilliant also has tons of other really interesting courses on topics like astronomy, solar energy, computer memory, and special relativity, which similarly guide you along as you build your core knowledge. You can take as many of these incredibly designed courses as you want with their premium subscription, which, by being one of the first 755 people to click on the link in the description, you can get for 20% off.